Okay, last part we want to look at with a binomial distribution is calculating the mean and the variance. The mean for a binomial distribution is simply mu equals n times pi. That's it. Well, think about it this way. If you were getting a 10% payment for every item that you sell, and you sell 130 of them, well, 130 times 10, that's what you expect to get, right? Well, it's the same idea here. It's the exact same idea here. The mean is simply n, the number of trials, times pi, the probability of the individual success. So in this situation with Michelle that we just looked at, we said that mu was 0.783. And we know that n equals 13. There were 13 different trials. So, oops, I'm sorry, that's not mu, that's pi. I need to get my notation straight here. So this tells us collectively that mu must be equal to 13 times 0.783. Whip that into your calculator and see what you get. We'll come back to that and do that in the calculator in just a second. Let's see, the variance, sigma squared, is given as n times pi times 1 minus pi. So for this case with Michelle and the basketball thing, we say sigma squared equals 13 times pi, which is 0.783, times 1 minus pi, which is 1 minus 0.783. Now, what's the standard deviation? The standard deviation is simply sigma, which equals the square root of sigma squared, which should be the square root of 13 times 0.783 times 1 minus 0.783. Now, let's go to calculator and actually push a few numbers, a few buttons, and see what we get. Okay, the mean, we said, was 13 times 0.783, which is 10.1790. So on average, we expect if she's shooting 78.3% and she's shooting 13, taking 13 shots, we expect her to hit like 10.179. Now, obviously, she can't hit 0.179. So what does this average actually mean? Well, if she were to go to free throw line and shoot 13, and we record the number of hits, then she does it again, and we record the number of hits, then she does it again, and we record the number of hits. She keeps doing it over and over and over again. If we take the average of all those hits, we expect to be 10.179. This is kind of like, what's the average number of children per household? 2.3 or something like that? You show me the house with 0.3 of a kid. Well, it doesn't happen. But that's not what it means. That doesn't mean if you go to a house, you're going to actually find 2.3 kids. It means if you take the average of a bunch of houses, you expect it to be 2.3. Same thing here. If she repeat this whole thing over again, just shooting 13, repeat it over and over and over again, on average, we expect 10.179. Okay, the variance. The variance, we said, was 13 times 0.783 times 1 minus 0.783, which is 2.2088. There's the variance. And the standard deviation, just take the square root of that. I'm going to put the whole thing in again. 13 times 0.783 times 1 minus 0.78. And there is my standard deviation, 1.4862. Okay, that's going to wrap it up for the binomial distribution. And next, we're going to take a look at the normal distribution, our first continuous distribution. The binomial was discrete. The normal distribution is continuous.